Magandang hapon po sa lahat ng ating mga kababayan natin sa Northern and Southern Luzon, dito po sa Central Luzon, of course sa Metro Manila, sa Visayas, Mindanao, and mga OFWs natin, no? At tuloy-tuloy din yung pag-uwi ng iba at pag-welcome sa kanila. Pero yung mga OFWs natin na medyo grabe din yung mga protocol o yung enhanced quarantine sa ibang bansa, binabati namin kayo, sumunod lang kayo dyan sa rules dyan, at we're praying for you, no? So, this afternoon po, I'd like to discuss yung ano pa rin, yung pinakamainit na topic pa rin, yung paano po yung social amelioration program or yung 5 to 8,000, dahil medyo po may mga confusion. But let me start po with a Bible verse. It's Sunday and something to reflect on, no? Ito po. Okay. Enter through the narrow gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life. Only a few will find it. Yan pong nasa Matthew 7:13-14, no? So before we go into the program, it'll be a very holy week for all of us. Sa atin mga Kristiyano, 'di ba? Palm Sunday ngayon, and then we will meditate, discern, and pray about how the Lord God Jesus Christ gave His only begotten Son, that whoever shall believe shall not die but have eternal life, sa John 3:16. Sa mga kapatid nating Muslim, alam nating paumpisa na rin po ang Ramadan, so naghahanda din sila. Sa mga Jewish people around the world, di ba, yung Passover naman po ang kanilang ginaganap. And particularly challenging ngayon because hindi tayo makapag-congregate. Tao tayo. We want to be with each other. Di ba? Sabi nga, no person or no one is an island. We want to be together. We want to worship with each other. We crave to be with family and community, no? But definitely may tinuturo ang Panginoon sa atin. So this week po, let's not only look at COVID-19, at finances, the usual worldly things. I mean, tama, sinabi po sa Bible that man does not live on bread alone, but on every word from God. So yun yung spiritual side ng tao. But yung physical side ng tao, kailangan mo ng bread. Hindi naman sinabi ng Panginoon na man can live without bread, no? Sinasabi lang niya yung balanse. So let me now go to the discussion. Sumulat na pabalik yung DSWD. Thank you very much, Secretary Rolly, at sa buong DSWD. Let me start out by saying, iisa tayo ng intensyon sa ating Pangulo. So whether it's the President, it's the Economic Team, DSWD, LGU, Barangay Tanod, PNP, we want you to get the money at the fastest possible time with the least regulation or guidelines. So ulitin ko po ha, pati sa sulat po ni Secretary Rolly, nag-agree po siya. Nasabi niya, he agrees with us that in principle, that people sa pinakamabilis na oras makuha ng lahat ng qualified dun sa 18 million Filipino families ang pera with the least regulation or guidelines. Or sa common lingo natin, with the least red tape. Di ba? Okay. So given that principle, babaksak sa guidelines. So ano ba pakiusap sa amin nung March 21, nung kasama din namin si Sec Rolly, Economic Team, si Executive Secretary Miguel Dia, si Senate President Soto, ang sabi sa amin, pakiusap, kung pwede, medyo flexible yung batas, wag na natin i-complicate para may flexibility ang executive branch para ma-deliver ito kaagad. And simpleng-simple po ang idea, payagan sila ng flexibility, makahanap ng 200 to 300 billion. 200 billion na yan ay para sa social amelioration, and yung 75 billion yung pang-address sa mga kailangan ng health workers, PPEs, yung mga additional allowances, and anything else the government would need without affecting the fiscal standing. Ibig sabihin, life after COVID. Madaling guluhin ngayon yung budget at kunin lahat, no? Pero we also have to be very discerning. So yun yung agreement doon at yun po ay binigay namin, di ba? Halos 24 hours po kami nung araw na yon, March 23, Monday till Tuesday, nakauwi kami 4 p.m. But it was our pleasure, di ba? Masaya kami kahit puyat at pagod. Kahit the next 2 days sinabing may infected, hindi namin ni-regret. Bakit? Eh parati natin inuulit eh, dalawa ang pwedeng pumatay sa atin, yung virus or yung kakulangan sa pagkain at gamot, di ba? So, what will kill us first? Is it the virus or the quarantine? So, we don't want that question to be a question at all. Ang gusto po natin, you can pray, you can stay home, you can save lives, and may take-home package kayo. Kaya ginagamit ko parati yung psst, psst, di ba? So that it's very clear that we should pray, stay home, save lives, and then yung take-home package. Okay. So, nung pag-uusap namin ng March 21 hanggang sa March 23 and after that, nag-usap po kami na because we gave them minimal guidelines under the oversight committee, we have veto powers. That's the first time in the world. Doon mo makikita na very democratic ang ating Pangulo and he believes in the democratic process. First time nagkaroon ng oversight committee na may veto power. No, ibig sabihin, kung hindi maganda guidelines, pwede naming ipawalang saysay yon, no? So, when we talked with DSWD and the other secretaries sa IATF, sinabi namin, ayaw namin manahimik and then pagka tumagal o may problema, sasabihin namin sa iyo, we told you so. O sinabi ko na nga ba sa inyo eh. O kaya mag-hearing kami at para bang bida kami at kayong mali. Bakit? Kayo frontliners eh. We care for you, 'di ba? Even DSWD, kahit marami kaming reklamo lalo dito sa NCR, we care for you kasi kayo ang frontliners. Ganun din po sa LGUs. Lahat ng ginagawa po namin ngayon, no, parang ang nasa media kasi para bang magkalaban yung ibang congressman at saka local officials, hindi po totoo 'yon lalo po sa panahon ng kalamidad. I mean, there's one or two, but more or less po, everyone just wants to get the job done. So, ang mga mayors, mga kapitan, mga governors, nakikipag-usap din kami. Kaya ako na-late ng konti. I had a very, very good discussion with Mayor Isko. And if in the capital, Manila, they have that problem. If in sa lugar ko, di ba? Yes, I'm Speaker of the House, but we follow the rules, no? And kung makikita mo sa Taguig, ang binigay na census is 200,000, a little bit less than 200,000. Then, ang in-approve na bibigyan is 102,000, minus 10,000 na 4Ps. Pero sa aming sariling house-to-house survey, at hindi bago to, it's been going on for the last 9 years, 270,000 ang household sa Taguig. So, tinanong ko kay Mayor Isko, kamusta sa inyo? Sabi niya, well, ganun din speaker, no? 350,000 yung approved based on the 2015 census, pero 560,000 na ang households sa Maynila. So, you know, yung hindi natin dapat pag-awayan at sabihin nakakagulo ito o ganyan. Hindi, kaya nga kami nag-uusap ng DSWD. Naputo lang ang communication namin and I'm trying to find out why. Because we were making the guidelines with them and we were consulting with governors, mayors, barangay captains, and yung mga chairman ng iba't iba naming committee, no? So, linawin ko po muna ng klarong-klaro yung point po natin sa sinong dapat tumanggap. Okay? So, yung doon pupunta yung guidelines at doon kami nakikiusap pa ulit-ulit sa DSWD. As of now, they have 7 memorandum circulars. All of them are live. They just amend partially, pero none of them repealed the other ones, no? So from memorandum circular number 1 to memorandum circular number 7. So nakakalito ito sa mga tao at public officials. Number 1 rule sa communications, internal muna yung communication. Kung tayo-tayo hindi nagkakaintindihan, isang pamilya lang tayo, paano tayo maiintindihan ng iba o ng komunidad natin o ng barangay o ng purok natin, no? So on that point, klaro naman ang hinihingi lang namin sa DSWD kasi anyone now, I've been seeing sa Facebook, iba't ibang barangay, iba't ibang senador, iba't ibang congressman, iba't ibang mayor, iba ang nakalagay kung sinong kasalit hindi. And they're not necessarily wrong, di ba? For example, meron pong iba nakalagay doon, let's say, sa single mother or sa senior citizen or sa four piece. Yung iba sabi kasali, yung iba hindi. They're not correct or wrong, no? It's yung four piece ay kasama talaga sa 18 million pero may separate program for that na diretso ibibigay sa kanila. Ngayon, yung mga member ng UCT, unconditional cash transfer, and some of them are seniors, solo parents, meron din silang cash card, diretso din sa kanila. So in the sense na hindi sila kasama sa bibigyan ng barangay, pero kasama sila sa bibigyan ng 5 to 8,000. That's why nga, we're batting for simplicity. Yun po ang hinihingi natin sa DSWD. Okay, so let me go to the process, no? Yung proseso po, pinakita ko naman po sa inyo, di ba? Yung pag-analyze po namin ng proseso, pakita ko po sa inyo, ha? Ito po yung proseso sa MC number 1 hanggang sa MC number, mula sa MC number 1 hanggang sa MC number 4, etong dalawang page ang proseso. Okay? So binilang po namin yan, more or less yan po ay 30 steps bago po umabot sa bago umabot yung pera sa atin. So, I mean sa inyo. So, bago umabot sa house to house. So, we uncomplicated it by proposing 4 steps. And niyaya namin na mag-conference or mag-Zoom, kahit virtual ang DSWD, para isa-isahin. And if you look at our letter, ang nalagay namin doon, hindi na mali o tama to, nilagyan namin to clarify or if we disagree and may counter-proposal. So, sinagot tayo today, but kung makikita nyo po, ito po yung chart na ibinigay po, no? It's on my iPad. Makikita nyo po, no? Ito, to provide social amelioration card, 1 day. Okay? Mass production of forms ng LGUs, 2 days. Door-to-door distribution at saka pick-up, 2 days. Okay? To encode the form, 3 days. To field office DSWD, 1 day. And submit, 1 day. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10. 10 days yan. Tapos ang sinasabi, naklaro naman na daw nila yung guidelines sa memorandum order, MC6. Yung MC6 po ay January 31. So assuming you start on April 1, I don't think na dapat umabot ng April 10 bago nyo matanggap yung pera nyo. That's a counter-proposal namin, 3 to 5 days, nasa inyo na yung pera. Eto, 10 days, hindi pa nyo sure nandun sa inyo ang pera. Yes, there has to be accountability. That's why pagka inisa-isa mo yung prosesong binigay natin, ay makikita mo meron accountability doon. Don't get us wrong, no? DSWD did not disagree with us on everything. They agreed with us at binago nila yung guideline na download na kagad yung pera. Huwag na nila hintayin yung forms and everything from the LGU kasi baka ma-delay. They agreed with us na house to house. They agreed with us and thank you very much sa COA. We helped together, put our minds together, give suggestions para nga pumayag na picture na lang sa bahay-bahay kasi may cellphone naman ng mga tao rather than papirmahan sa receive. So we have done good work together, no? Naputo lang yung communication sa nung Wednesday, and Sec Rolly, kung makikinig ka, di ba? I mean, magkasama tayo sa kabinete. I understand napaka-busy. I understand that there are long-time career and bureaucrats in your office that think otherwise. But lahat nakukuha sa pag-uusap eh. No? And wala namang problema kung nasunod yung sinabi ng presidente na DSWD ni, kayo na, wala nang politiko. Ang problema, hindi rin kaya ng DSWD without tapping the local government. And I'm doing this primarily for our people, for the 18 million families na makuha ang pera, but secondarily, sa LGUs. Naging mayor din ang asawa ko, mayor ngayon ang kapatid ko. halos mga kaibigan ko are either kapitans, mayors, governors, di ba? Ang dami. I don't want na parang isipin nyo, dinump lang sa inyo ng national government. We're in crisis, bahala na kayo. Kasi hindi yan ang intention ng Pangulo, di ba? Ang intention ng Pangulo, kayo muna, the first few days, and then afterwards, the national government come in with the resources. But what's happening on the ground? Yung LGUs, tatlo ang task. One is to maintain the quarantine. Number two is to implement the public health strategy, meaning provide ambulance, frontliners, to ask the PUI, PUMs na huwag lumabas ng bahay. Kung may mag-positive at kailangan dalhin ng ospital, sila mag-aasikaso. Ang mga mayors din po ang nagdadagdag ng beds, although the national government has come in. And thank you very much, Presidential Advisor Vince Dison, no? And the whole team. Thank you to the economic team for supporting, and yung mga donors, no? And then the third po na kailangan gawin ng LGU, social amelioration. So yes, everyone is busy. No, kahit ako po, halos siguro 8 to 12 hours. Ang hingi lang ni Lani is 1 meal a day. Magkasama kami kasi total naka-quarantine kami together. But even during lunch and during dinner, I'm all on the phone all the time. No? At alam ng mga kausap ko na to, lalo yung mga kongresista and yung staff, yung speakers team that we're working with, no? And the businessmen and the other health experts na tinatawagan ko now and then, no? So, which goes to the forms, okay? So, may konting confusion ngayon or mahigit konti about the forms. Bakit po? Kasi last week po, sinabi ko, lahat bigyan ng forms. Bakit ko po nasabi yan? Kasi po, nagbasa ako ng guidelines at araw-araw namin kausap ang DSWD. At tinanong namin sila, pwede bang wala ng form? Sabi nila, hindi pwede kasi paano natin maja-judge kung qualified o hindi kung wala tayong data. Walang problema sa 6 million, almost 6 million, yan po ang 4Ps at saka yung UCT kasi may data na sila. May additional 3 million po sila na may data sila pero wala pang cash card. Okay, so sa 18 million nakabuuan na pamilyang Pilipino na bibigyan ng 5 to 8,000, 4.4 million 4Ps, almost another million and a half yung UCT and other. And then yun lahat may cash card, kaya walang problema yan. You should get your money ASAP na, no? Dinideposito na, makukuha nyo sa cash card nyo yan. Pero yung 9 million, yung 3 million na poor din, or near poor, may listahan pero walang cash card. And then may additional 9 million ka kasi nga naka-enhanced community quarantine tayo. So, ang sabi ng DSWD, kailangan mo yung form para ma-assess natin. And then, apat ang steps nila for approval or validation. Va-validate ng barangay, i-encode, i-validate ng social worker, i-validate ng munisipyo, tapos i-validate ng central office. So sabi namin, masyado maraming validation, tatagal to masyado, di ba? Parang, yes, ayaw natin magkamali, ayaw natin madoble, ayaw natin may corruption. Pero kung gutom na tao, patay na kabayo, bago nila makuha, you know, the safe, kaya nga graft and corruption eh. Yung corruption, yung ninakaw mo yung pera. Yung graft, yung sa sobrang inefficiency, may damage. And in this case, the damage is to life eh. Diba? If people don't get their medicines, hindi lang naman COVID-19 ang problema. Marami pong hikain, marami pong may diabetes, marami pong may high blood na hindi nakakapag-trabaho ngayon, hindi nila nakukuha ang gamot nila. That's why nga very wise po ang economic team led by Secretary Dominguez and Secretary Avisado in saying cash ang ibigay. Kasi whether toiletries yan for proper hygiene, whether food, whether gamot, diba? Yan po ay kayo na magdesisyon at bukas naman po yung mga tindahan around you, di ba? Or at least yung mga groceries. So yun po ang kabuuan kung bakit kailangan ng form. So biglang sinabi sa amin, sir, hindi nyo pa maproproduce yung form sa mga local kasi kailangan ng barcode. So yun po sinulat namin sa kanila na pampatagal po ito at gagamitin nyo naman yung barcode to verify after. We can have a validation house to house. We'll make it very quickly. How? One day, i-print yung form. The next day, i-distribute. In the same day or the next morning, kasama na yung validation team. House to house, binavalidate kung sinong may kailangan. And then, after that, payroll na, pwede nang ibigay sa tao ang pera. So, kaya namin sinabing 3 to 5 days, depende gano'ng kabilis yung LGU. We want to help the LGUs. So, mga kapitan, mga konsehal, mga bukal, mga governors, vice governors, mayors, vice mayors, vice governors, we're doing this to help you. And the congressmen are every day thinking of ways, aside from legislation, how to help even through oversight and yung kanya-kanya ding mga donation. So yung bawat block natin, let's say yung Metro Manila, and then gumawa din kami ng Greater Metro Manila, may proposals at may concerns yan na every day, no? Okay, so saan nagkaroon ng confusion? Ngayon, biglang dinagdagan ng DSWD, hindi lang ng barcode but control number. And then, binago din po yung sinabi sa amin na initially ha, ang numbers and I think it's here, no? Let me see. Initially, yung numbers ay ang usapan initially kung ano yung nasa 2015 census. But we know that's 5 years ago and we know na nung build, marami din lumipat sa mga highly urbanized area, Metro Davao, Metro Cebu, Baguio City, Tarlac, Pampanga area, and Metro Manila, no? So, ito po yung nilabas nilang list. Yan po ang binigay nilang initial. Pero tignan nyo po sa Metro Manila, no? Ano, saan yung iba kong form? Sandali ha. Meron po ako, pinacompute ko yung percentage dito eh. Ito po. Okay. So, walang problema po sa BI, ito po, sa BARM, dahil po 93% mabibigyan. Sa Region 12, 83%. Sa Region 10, 80%. No? Pero dito po sa Metro Manila, 54% lang ang mabibigyan. Hindi po problema yan kung 54 or 55% lang ang may kailangan. Pero katulad nga po sa Maynila na 350,000 naging 560, saan kukunin ni Mayor Isko yung additional 200,000? And dun po sa mga nagrereklamo pong mga kapitan at etc. at sinasabing gumugulo, kaya po tayo nag-advocate, kaya natin ine-exercise yung atin oversight powers, kaya nga nakapirma sa sulat namin ay yung members ng oversight committee para linawin, no? So, ang sabi ngayon, may listahan na daw ang DSWD, kung ilan, yun lang ang bibigay sa'yo na form. So let me tell you the problems that will create. I asked Mayor Isko, I asked Mayor Lino, and nakiusap ako kay Mayor Lino, tanungin sa ibang ibang mayor hanggang sa kapitan, kung totoo o hindi na ayaw ibigay ng DSWD yung listahan ng 4Ps sa kanila. Pare-pareho ang sagot po sa akin. Pati po dun sa nakikipag-usap sa amin from DSWD, they agree, hindi po sila magbibigay ng pangalan ng 4Ps. So kasama sa sulat namin yan, na pasok pa rin sa data privacy law na ibigay nila sa mayors yung names. Why? Okay, like in Taguig, ang in-approve 102,000 families. 92,000 families daw i-identify namin o ng local government yung 10,000 4Ps. Pero hindi nila sinasabi sino yung 4Ps. So, kung 92,000 lang ang bibigyan mo, samantalang ang qualified ay 160,000-170,000, mapipilitan si kapitan, mapipilitan si mayor na mamili sinong pinakamahirap, sinong pinakanangangailangan. And usually, ang pinakanangangailangan, 4Ps. Kaya nga tinanong ko kay Mayor Isko, anong ginawa mo, mayor? Eh, sinabit daw niya sa DSWD, kung sino yung binibigyan at pinakamahirap, ang DSWD daw ang magtatanggal kung sino yung sa 4Ps. E di ganun din, humaba pa yung proseso, di ba? So, yan ang isang example po. So, problema po ng mga kapitan ngayon, limit kulang na nga yung forms nyo, pero pag pinamigay nyo, pag binigay nyo sa membro ng 4Ps at pinirmahan yan, nawalan kayo ng isang pamilya na pwedeng bigyan. Diba? Pwede sabihin hindi dumoble kasi chinek naman niya na 4Ps siya. So hindi niyo siya bibigyan. Pero ang ibibigay sa inyo, eksaktong number ng forms. Kagabi, medyo late na po ako. Actually, madaling araw na po ako natulog. So, I was watching Cabsec Carlo Nograles sa TV. At yung isang tanong sa kanya nung netizen, pag ako ay hindi botante sa lugar ko, kung nasaan ako ngayon, bibigyan din ba ako? And very, very clear ang sagot niya. That they discussed that sa IATF, voter's ID or being a voter in that area is not a requirement. In fact, yung mga stranded ay dapat tulungan. And by the way, ha, may tulungan tayo. I'm thankful very much sa DSWD. Agad nilang tinugon yung panawagan. Medyo tinulay lang po natin ang panawagan ng UP Los Baños Chancellor na libo-libong estudyante ang stranded po sa UPLB. Nagre-raise lang silang money na makakain twice a day. At agad rumresponde po ang DSWD, and we're still coordinating kasi meron pang estudyante. So there's no conflict between us and DSWD. This is a professional discussion, no? But we're involving the public because you have the right to know. Katulad ng sinabi ko, pag ganitong crisis, isang pamilya tayo, being candid and honest and discussing everything in the public will take out any suspicion between everyone. So dun po sa example ni Carlo, no? Secretary Cabsec Carlo. So paano ngayon kung hindi kilala ng kapitan yung stranded sa kanila or yung hindi botante? So hindi mo bibigyan ng form. So hindi siya ma-assess. So hindi na nga siya nakasama, hindi pa siya nabigyan ng form. So may iba po kasi, kanya-kanya po kasing philosophy yan eh. Yung iba, ang philosophy nila, huwag mong bibigyan ng form, baka mag-expect. So let me make this clear, no? The economic team has package 1, which is for the 18 million Filipino families, the poor and near poor, informal sector ng ating ekonomiya, and for the health and medical professionals, including PPEs. May package 2 na parating, which is for the formal sector, including the micro, small, and medium enterprises. But the government has continuing programs, for example, sa microfinance, ang ating pong central bank, halimbawa, ay ang daming pagkilos na ginagawa para sa mga negosyo at banko. And then Andole, for example, is on top of some of them who are in the formal sector. So yun po yung 6.6 million families para mabuo yung 24.6 million Filipino families. So ang sinasabi ko po, by giving everyone the form, you will be able to evaluate and identify and validate sinong dapat bigyan at sinong hindi. So halimbawa ngayon, in-announce nila kung meron ka kahit isa sa pamilya na senior, na meron PWD, meron solo parent. So lahat yan nag-expect. Pag hindi mo binigyan ng form yan, niwala silang chance to prove that they're qualified, no? So yung iba sinasabi, huwag magbigay ng masyadong maraming form kasi baka mag-expect. Eh, habang binibigay mo, sinasabi mo naman eh, sir, ma'am, eto po gagamitin natin to evaluate. Pero yung alam niyang qualified siya at wala man lang siyang form, eh wala na siyang pag-asa. So that's why nagtaka ako bakit biglang nagbago yung usapan at pag-uusap namin with DSWD na ngayon sila na namili kung ilan. Nung una sinabi initial lang yon, no? That's why I'm making a personal appeal, no? Not only sa ating pangulo, sa economic team, sa DSW, IATF, masyadong maliit yung 54% sa Metro Manila. If you're making a mistake by 10%, that's 320,000 families. And I know hindi yun ang intention, no? At hindi yun ang gusto ng economic team, hindi yan ang gusto ng gobyerno, hindi yan ang gusto namin sa legislature, hindi yan ang gusto ng mga senador. But of course, kailangan maghanap ng pera kasi it already equals 17,956,000 and another 93 families, no? So we really have to look at the statistics and we have to look at to find a solution here. But I'll show you another thing that will bolster my argument, no? Dun sa mga kapitan na or yung iba nagtatanong. Ayan po, guidelines po to mismo ng DSWD. The barangay shall identify and prepare the list of qualified beneficiaries based on eligibility requirements provided in these guidelines. The listed beneficiaries will be profiled through the use of social amelioration card. So malinaw po yan, ha? Ang mag-identify barangay, titingnan nila qualified profile from the social amelioration card. Meaning, kung wala kang card, hindi ka kasama sa iproprofile, wala ka ng pag-asa. So the SAC or social amelioration card shall be the mechanism of eligibility. Shall be the mechanism of eligible families to access any social amelioration program from any government agency, including the DSWD. Okay? Ayan po, tapos, ito po, kasama namin binuo po yan. The identified personal barangay will conduct a house-to-house distribution. A house-to-house distribution of the SAC forms. Diba? Okay. So let me go back to that, no? Kung alam nyo na kung sino at fix na yung number mo, ba't pa tayo magbibigay ng card? Magpasubmit na lang tayo ng listahan. Ngayon, sinasabi natin, meron mahuhulog sa DA katulad ng Fisher Folk at ibang farmers. May mahuhulog po sa, or may masasakop po ang DOLE, may masasakop ang DOTR. But under your joint guidelines, it's the social amelioration card that will determine kung ano ang, kung saan programa ka. So, kung hindi mo bibigyan ng card lahat, no? So, meaning, may nakita kang malaking bahay, tinanong mo, kinatok mo, boss, ilan ang pamilya dyan? Apat. Ay, sorry po, isang form lang kayo. So, may tatlong pamilya doon na cannot even argue whether or not sakop sila. Now, what if you give them four forms? Yung isa yung may-ari ng bahay, and clearly may income, clearly may kaya, clearly, nasa formal sector. So, sabihin mo, ma'am, hindi po kayo kasama. Kung hindi makabayad ng renta yung makasama mo, may ibang programa ang gobyerno dyan. O, the other family, nasa formal sector. Kasi nasa hotel nagtatrabaho, for example, or, and continuing sweldo. So, i-explain lang sila, boss, hindi ka kasama kasi tuloy-tuloy ang sweldo mo. But the two other families ay kasama. No? So, that's the value po that we will have forms for everyone, no? We cannot play politics here. We cannot think na pag binigyan magtatampo. Kahit anong mangyari dito, may magtatampo. Kasi supply and demand 'yan eh. 'Di ba? Lahat kailangan, lahat gustong mabigyan. So we're just trying to put more logic and sense into all of this. So let me show you the form. Nakita niyo na 'to, but let me show it to you again, no? Okay. Ayan po yung form at makikita nyo po, medyo kompleto sa datos at pati kung ano sakit nung pamilya, anong kondisyon, ano yung mga sakit and everything, no? So, kung hindi ka mabibigyan ng form, paano malalaman ng DOH, for example, yung mga may high blood at kailangan ng gamot, di ba? So, paano po malalaman ng IATF kung ilan ang vulnerable sector? Kasi part of asking the pre-existing medical condition is not only for the social amelioration. It's also for our scientists, especially yung data scientists and medical professionals, to see gaano ka-vulnerable ang population sa isang lugar, because we know that COVID-19 hits worse dun sa mga may underlying medical condition. So, kung hindi ka mabibigyan ng form, walang record yung gobyerno tungkol sa iyo, no? Then going back to the process, 'di ba? Why do you have to encode for 3 days when may form ka naman? So gamitin mo na yung form para ibigay yung pera, then afterwards sa kanyo i-encode dahil may pangalawang bigayan pa naman sa Mayo. So siguro at this point you'll ask me, eh bakit yung verse na shinare nyo sa umpisa is about, you know, the way to heaven being narrow and the gates to hell being wide? May kasabihan din po eh that the road to hell is paved with good intention. The president will die first before allowing Filipinos and the country to go to hell. No, I'm speaking po in human terms, in governance, no. Ayaw niyang magutom kayo, ayaw niya po na magkasakit kayo, ayaw niya po na may mamatay. That's why the president has been diligent in running government even during this crisis, no? That's why the economic team is focused in trying to help everyone, no? So having said that po, sinabi ko yan kasi marami po maganda intention, pati po kami. But this is not you versus us. I want to say, LGU, I'm on your side. But if I say LGU on your side, does that mean kalabang ko DSWD? Hindi po. We're all on one side. The other side is COVID-19, no? So I hope ang dami ko pang gustong i-discuss, but may tumatawag na po sa akin from the economic team, and I think very good po yung suggestion that we clear this up by the DSWD and myself or Congress having a joint statement, no? But very important din na ma-clear up lahat ng issues na to. And dun po sa mga medyo nahihirapan, pasensya na po kayo. Again, we're on your side, we're on the same side. Dun po nagsasabi, paano to? 2,000 ang bibigyan sa amin, 800 lang ang binigay. Ano yung sinasabi ni Cayetano na kailangan ng form? Hindi, no? We are debating and we are talking to each other as a nation because we don't want anyone to die. We don't want anyone to die because of COVID-19. We don't want you to die because of hunger. We don't want you to die because kulang kayo sa gamot. So let's please help each other. So let me end with a positive note, no? Despite etong discussion, na-download na yung pera at yung mga LGUs are full steam ahead. So mga kaibigan ng mga kapitan, mga kagawad, mga zone leader, purok leader, ating pong mga mayor, kung anong allotment nyo, make do muna, ibigay nyo sa pinaka nangangailangan, but Congress is here working at your side, the economic team is working, the DSWD is working to get you more resources so that lahat matulungan natin, no? So again, it's Sunday, please worship with your community, please say a prayer for all of us, and hopefully there'll be wisdom coming from the Lord today. God bless you all, magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat.